70% of Nigeria's population engages in agricultural production at subsistence level. However, much of the Nigerian economy since the discovery of oil is driven by oil. With the advent of oil, agriculture was relegated to the background, and despite this unfortunate situation, the sector remained and accounts for about 42% of the gross domestic product GDP. Following the world food crisis and particularly the worsening food security situation in Africa, heads of states and government of Africa at the summit in Maputo in 2004 decided to provide a stronger political support to the Comprehensive Africa Agricultural Development Program, CAADP. Also, greater proportion of the population depend on the agricultural sector for their livelihood, and the rural economy is still basically agricultural. The role of the agricultural sector in the overall response of the Nigerian economy to reforms and adjustment policies is very important because, given its relatively large size, a large positive response to adjustment policies was expected as a means of improving the overall performance of the economy.
Actually, Fidan Investment have started operation 1998, actually in Nigeria. The MD, Mr. Mustafa, who is not in the country recently, is a graduate of animal science from American University of Beirut. Started the company with as little as 3,000 breeders. So the company started with a rented farm. Actually, not also rented farm, a shared farm, because we weren't having enough money to rent a complete farm then. So we started 1998 with 3,000 breeders. Started our hatchery in 2002, the operation of the hatchery. Then by 2003, acquired our first farm, which is at Olubadan village, almost 25 acres of land, which is now in full capacity that can contain up to 70,000 breeders. That's our first farm. In 2006, we were able to obtain another farm at Alomaja Industrial Estate with almost capacity of 25,000 breeders. In 2012, also acquired a land in Ogumakin area that can contain also 25,000 birds. And all the lands was bought by the company without any financial assistance from any bank. So we were focused about the business itself in Nigeria, when everybody was thinking of importation and making easy money. But we were focused at this point of view that especially poultry is going to be one of the biggest industries in the nation. So from there, our aim was investing and reinvesting. You know, as you see us, we normally don't call ourselves foreigners anymore. We are more related to the soil now. Actually, we spend more than half of our life in Nigeria. So we are more and more related to the soil and to the people of this country. Actually, let's go to back to our olden days, which where I was not around, but I read and I follow up the news. I believe in the 80s, Nigeria was one depending mostly on agric, especially cocoa, palm, and a lot of other things. That's before getting to know that we have crude oil. So then, agric used to play a very good economic growth in the country, but unfortunately, when we got to know that we have oil, everybody forgotten about the agric, lot of cocoa plantations were just abandoned. A lot of palm plantation also was abandoned. If you go, maybe if you are going to Shaki side, you see on left and right, everywhere palm trees were just abandoned. Agric in any part of the world plays one of the most goals in the economy.
The change mantra of the federal government in the agricultural sector in the current dispensation seems to have taken cognizance of the relevance and the position of the agriculture sector. Hence, the 2016 budget is tailored towards the sector and as well as the solid mineral to drive the process. The development will further encourage the stakeholders in the sector to double their effort and their participation and channel more resources and expertise to grow the agricultural sector in Nigeria.
First to finance. Finance is, let's say, part of the challenge, but the most challenge we have is the infrastructure to have a good agri-business. Let's say about ourselves, as we are in poultry. As of today, our main problem is we don't have grain facilities, let's say in the state. We don't have any grain facility that can help farmers whenever you are having glut. For instance, now we are buying maize at 115 naira, which is very expensive. And when I'm going to buy feed at a very high expensive rate, our end product cost price is going to be also very expensive, which is going to affect the masses. Because you know, when you have very expensive product, not everybody can buy it. So that's what's even given a serious problem of selling the end product to the masses. That when you're having a minimum wage maybe of 18,000 naira, at this point now you cannot wait and see those people. They won't be able to buy this product because the product itself is very expensive to the masses. So that's one of the point of the problems. Financially, also banks doesn't give facilities anyhow, and they make it sometimes harder to the investors. While in other part of the countries, You see banks, maybe backed up by government, giving loans at a very low rate, which I know now they have a new scheme, CBN, to empower farmers. So I believe the two sides have an effect on the agri sector. Okay, our main product actually is the old chicks. So the unique is that when we are producing our day-old chicks, we do most of our effort to have a very high quality chicks, because in poultry the main issue when you are starting a poultry farm is the source of not only day-old chicks or cow, piggery, whatever. The source you get, maybe your day-old chick or maybe your small cattle, to start it on. So if you are having a high quality, you have a good start on. For instance, the first 2 weeks of a chicken determines the whole life. So if your day-old is of a quality, your second partner, which is a customer, we don't call them customers, we call them partners, because without them we don't. So when they have a good quality chick, themselves and their farm, they are going to enjoy the benefit and the productivity of that chick. Actually, either if it is layers, if it is broilers, so you can have a very good product at end product. And we try to use the best materials we can afford. Let me just put it in that way, because it's not every time you can afford good materials to use, like feed materials, like biosecurity materials, disinfectant, feed additives. We actually don't have any in Nigeria. Most of these are imported, which I also take this interview that by now we should have at least one or two companies that produce feed additives in Nigeria, because we are a very high consuming country with 180 million people. So you consume a lot. So I think this is the time now for everybody to believe in local production of almost all what we use. We are good consumers. Our first advisor for the committee is to do a good environment for investors, or let's say to provide a good environment for any investor in the poultry, in the agri, in crops. So good environment, what do I mean by good environment? Good roads, good electricity, grains, good storage of grains, having enough grains. Because our main problem we are facing actually is the grains issue. Like now, if let's just say if I am buying at 115,000 naira for maize, which is close to $350. But worldwide, this product itself doesn't sell more than $110 and anywhere in the world, between $110 to $140. That's for countries that produces maize. And we are one of the big countries that we can also produce a very good crop. We have a good soil. Actually, God has blessed us with a very good soil. So, but the infrastructure is not there. Like 2 months ago, we went to some local governments where they grow grains and all of that. So they shouted out that if government, let's say, gives a community a tractor, a farmer that can grow maybe 10 acres of land, he's ready to do 30 acres. But when he doesn't have a tractor, he has to do it manually. You understand? It will delay him. So, and I believe in other communities may be the same. But from the ones we heard, that's why we went to Isseyin then to see some of our farmers, our suppliers also of maize. We also help them when the season comes to buy their maize, and when there is no season, to tell them how to do land, grow, get a hybrid seedlet that can give them a good grain, a good crop. Well, to me, we believe it may be hard a bit that you are collecting money and giving product if you don't know who you are giving the money to. So actually, if it is in our ground, that if it is to me, we will only go and give the starter farmers. You know, the way now, Bank of Industry, let's say, want to give you, for an example,
20 billion.
Let's say five million naira for you to start a farm. If you are not, how will I put it? If you are not an expert, you may end up losing the money, having problems with Bank of Industry. So we prefer the money should be given to experts. That's number one. Not to be given to anybody, just giving documents. That Bank of Industry should have maybe a committee from expert farmers. Anybody want to take a loan or money from the government and giving products in return, they should see what's the background of this farmer. That how long have you been into the farming sector? What did you produce? You see the results. I mean, if you go to the farm, every farm has their result cards, their schedule on how taking in and out stocks. So if you follow it up, you know, this is okay, this is a farmer. I believe if I give him money, he's going to give me back my money. But if you go to any farmer that is just starting, where you also see a lot of new starters, you may end up losing the money. Him losing his job, or maybe the collateral he used for the facility or whatever, and we end up in a serious problem. Well, as I told you, Nigeria is a very high consuming country. From our last study we did, what we produce in protein sector is not more than 25% of what we consume, actually. Most of the rest is imported, either fish, beef, chicken, pork, whatever has been imported. So our production, we are just at less than 25% of what we consume. So I believe in the next 2 years, and with the high price of exchange rate, you may see more investors coming into this sector, and we may see the sector in a very good condition in the next 2 years. But with government giving a good environment, I say it again, a good environment for farmers, and giving a good crop prices. You know, this crop issues is only going to be controlled by government.